present sponsored testimony for House Bill 294. I want to begin by giving each of you a question to ponder. This is bad oath for all. Had elementary biology, I think you might agree. Who among us can say when the spirit is sparked into a human being? To quote Dr. Robert George, a professor of jurisprudence at Princeton University, when a sperm joins yolk, these two individual cells cease to be, and their union generates a new and distinct organism. This organism is whole through beginning development into the human species. At the end of our lives, we have choices that we can make. Why are these rights denied in the earliest stages of life? Specifically to another area of great concern, the racial disparities in abortion are of grave concern and should be to all of us. According to the 2014 U.S. Census data, African Americans make up 12.6% of Ohio's population, yet had 39% of the reported abortions in Ohio, make up 52.7% of the death sentences, people that are sentenced to death on death row. That many abortions, over half the people on death row. There's something wrong with that picture. The infant mortality rate for Ohio is 7.4% overall, 6.6% for white babies, and 13.8% for African American babies. We're consistently failing our families, babies, for future generations. Groups are getting funding like infant mortality reduction, child and family health. We still have these rates. Someone is not doing a good job. Despite our personal feelings, I think we can agree that when you sign a contract and receive money from the state or federal government, that money should be used for the purpose in which it's earmarked. If you receive money for HIV and AIDS, then that money has to be used for those programs. The same is true for maternal and child health plans. And I just want to add to that, yes, I am a father of four, grandfather of six. And too long in this story have men been left out. And that we escape the guilt associated. The lie, say baby's born, comes in full-blooded bloodhounds, and they should. Prior to that, you said, not my son or my daughter. And what happens to it? Should I at least be involved in it, given credit, or whatever? So my sense of this whole thing is very